Hello everyone, I'm Ms. Zarina Sheikh, English teacher of grade 7. Today in this orientation session, I'm here to share with you some vital information regarding Cambridge Lower Secondary English Stage 8 curriculum and school-based assessments. Cambridge Lower Secondary English enables learners to communicate confidently and effectively and develop critical skills to respond to a range of information, media and text with understanding and enjoyment. Grade 7 will have two English books, namely Complete English for Cambridge Secondary 1 Stage 8 Coursebook and Cambridge Grammar Gearbook 7. Students will have two notebooks for English, one 200 pages notebook for classwork and homework and 100 pages notebook for class test. Regarding school-based assessments, students of grade 7 will have English internal assessment for 30 marks in term 1 and term 2. English internal assessment comprises of components with class tests for 15 marks, reading, speaking and listening test each for 5 marks. Reading, speaking and listening tests will be conducted twice in each term. The highest marks scored in each test will be awarded to the students. For more details and schedule of English internal assessment, kindly refer to the school diary. Due to the current COVID pandemic, all the classes and exams are bound to be conducted online till the situation returns to normalcy. For online Unit Test 1 and Unit Test 2, Grade 7 will have one English theory paper of 20 marks and oral exam of 10 marks, total 30 marks. For online Term 1 and Term 2 exam, Grade 7 will have two English theory papers with English paper 1 of 35 marks and English paper 2 of 35 marks and oral exam of 20 marks, total 120 marks. Fortunately, in the coming days, when the COVID pandemic subsides and normalcy prevails, the classes and exams will be conducted in the school. If exams are conducted offline in school, then in Unit Test 1 and Unit Test 2, there will be only one English paper of 25 marks, there will be no oral exam. Similarly, for offline Term 1 and Term 2 exam, there will be only two theory papers with English paper 1 and English paper 2 each of 35 marks, internal assessment of 30 marks, total 100 marks. There will be no oral exam. For more details regarding online and offline school-based assessments, kindly refer to the school diary. I take this opportunity to give you an insight into the contents of the English theory papers applicable for both offline as well as online unit tests and term exams. In Unit Test 1 and Unit Test 2, the questions will be asked from the English coursebook, notebook and grammar gearbook. There will be creative writing section also. In creative writing section, students will have to write descriptive articles, newspaper or magazine articles, news report, stump, story, summary, email, etc. on any given topic in their own words. In Term 1 and Term 2, in English paper 1, questions will be asked from the grammar gearbook and there will be creative writing section. In English paper 2, there will be one or two unseen passages for reading and comprehension and questions will be asked from the English coursebook and notebook. So this is all about grade 7 English curriculum and assessments for the academic year 2021-22. If you have any query, kindly email at zarina.sicis@gmail.com. Wishing all the students a very exhilarating and successful new academic year ahead. Take care and stay safe. Thank you. Have a nice day.
सभी अभिभावकों को एवं विद्यार्थियों को हिंदी टीचर सीमा चतुर्वेदी की शुभकामनाएं। मैं आपके समक्ष कक्षा छठवीं, सातवीं एवं आठवीं के वार्षिक पाठ्यक्रम के साथ उपस्थित हुई हूँ। सर्वप्रथम मैं आपको ऑफलाइन के विवरण को प्रस्तुत करती हूँ। मैं आपके सामने आंतरिक मूल्यमापन, आंतरिक मूल्यमापन तीन बिंदुओं पर आधारित होगा। वाचन 5 अंक, श्रुत लेखन 5 अंक, संभाषण 5 अंक, कुल 15 अंक होंगे। इसी प्रकार कक्षा मूल्यांकन 15 अंकों का होगा, कुल आंतरिक मूल्यमापन 30 अंकों का होगा। तत्पश्चात इकाई परीक्षा की मैं बात करती हूँ। इकाई परीक्षा में प्रथम इकाई परीक्षा एवं द्वितीय इकाई परीक्षा। प्रथम द्वितीय इकाई परीक्षा के प्रश्न पत्र 25 अंकों के होंगे। इसके बाद वार्षिक परीक्षा आती है। वार्षिक परीक्षा के प्रश्न पत्र 70 अंकों के होते हैं प्रथम सत्र परीक्षा एवं द्वितीय सत्र परीक्षा, इनके अंक 70 अंकों के होते हैं, 30 अंक आंतरिक मूल्यमापन के उसमें समाहित किए जाते हैं, कुल योग 100 अंकों का होता है। अब मैं आपके समक्ष ऑनलाइन परीक्षा की बातें करती हूँ, बताती हूँ। उसमें आंतरिक मूल्यमापन, वाचन 5 अंक, श्रुत लेखन 5 अंक, संभाषण 5 अंक, कुल 15 अंक, कक्षा मूल्यांकन 15 अंक, कुल 30 अंक होंगे। प्रथम इकाई परीक्षा एवं द्वितीय इकाई परीक्षा के प्रश्न पत्र 20 अंकों के होंगे, 10 अंक मौखिक के, कुल 30 अंक होंगे। उसके बाद वार्षिक परीक्षा आती है। वार्षिक परीक्षा में प्रथम सत्र परीक्षा 70 अंक का पेपर होगा, 30 अंक आंतरिक मूल्यमापन के उसमें समाहित किए जाएंगे, 20 अंक मौखिक प्रश्न पत्र के होंगे, कुल योग 120 अंकों का होगा। इसी तरह सत्रांत परीक्षा के भी प्रश्न पत्र 70 अंकों के होंगे, 30 अंक आंतरिक मूल्यमापन के होंगे और 20 अंक मौखिक प्रश्न के होंगे, कुल योग 120 अंकों का। इसके पश्चात भी आपको कोई संदेह हो, किसी बात की जानकारी चाहते हैं आप, तो कृपया seema.sicis@gmail.com पर निसंकोच संपर्क करें। आप सभी लोगों का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
नमस्कार, मी नीलिमा निकुम, मराठी विषयाची विशेष शिक्षिका। आज आपण इयत्ता 6वी ते 8वी या वर्गांकरिता असणारा मराठी विषयाचा अभ्यासक्रम पाहणार आहोत। इयत्ता 6वी ते 8वी या वर्गांकरिता पाठ्यपुस्तकात धडे, कविता, गोष्टी यांचा समावेश करण्यात आला आहे। या बरोबरच व्याकरण या भागामध्ये विविध प्रकारचे अव्यय जसे शब्दयोगी अव्यय, केवल प्रयोगी अव्यय, उभयानपदी अव्यय, तसेच वाक्प्रचार, म्हणी, शब्दसमूहाबद्दल एक शब्द अशा पद्धतीचा भाग असणार आहे। लेखन कौशल्यामध्ये विद्यार्थ्यांना निबंध लेखन, पत्र लेखन, संवाद लेखन असणार आहे। नंतर विद्यार्थ्यांना वेगवेगळ्या गोष्टींचं सादरीकरण किंवा वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारचे डायलॉग कशा पद्धतीने सादर करायचे याविषयी शिकवले जाईल। याबरोबरच विद्यार्थ्यांचे मूल्यमापन हे आंतरिक असणार आहे। मराठी हा विषय फक्त आंतरिक मूल्यमापनाकरता असणार आहे। याकरिता लेखन, वाचन व श्रवण याकरता प्रत्येकी 5 गुण असणार आहे, म्हणजेच ते 15 गुण व क्लास टेस्ट यांचे 15 गुण असे जवळजवळ 30 मार्कांचे आंतरिक मूल्यमापन असणार आहे। अशा पद्धतीने इयत्ता 6वी ते 8वी या वर्गांकरिता अगदी रोचक असं मराठी विषयाचा अभ्यासक्रम असणार आहे। धन्यवाद।
Good morning everyone, my name is Meghna Kargutkar. I'm going to be the French teacher for grades 5 to 10 and the homeroom teacher for grade 5. Today in this orientation, I will be giving you some vital information regarding the language French and the book that we are going to use, which is Encore Tricolore 2, that is for the grade 7. French being a foreign language, it helps us to improve our cognitive ability, which in turn helps us to speak effectively and efficiently. The French language learning is based on the 4 major principles of reading, listening, speaking and writing. Moving on to the objectives, the main objective of this portion will be focused on learning the different activities related to our own self, relating to family, relating to the culture of France, relating to college, relating to future activities, relating to accepting and denying things. The secondary objective is mostly based on the grammar point of view. grammar relating to different prepositions, pronouns, adverbs, adjectives, forming basic to complex sentences, to moderately complex sentences also, forming the regular verbs and the irregular verbs. Moving on to the assessment point of view. The assessment is based on internal point of view. Internally, the students will be assessed on four major components, that is reading, listening, speaking, and the class test. Reading, listening, speaking test will be based and assessed on the reading, listening, and speaking abilities of the child and also the pronunciation abilities. Whereas the class tests are small fragmented tests which are taken throughout the year. An average of these tests will be taken and added to the term exams marks. The term exams are two term exams of 70 marks each and unit tests of 25 marks each. French being a new subject and a new language, sometimes it is difficult to learn it. Hence, I advise all my students to do a little bit of self-study. Now, the self-study will include different types of dictation tests which you can do all by your own self, or listening to French music, listening to French songs which are available on the internet, watching French videos. All these kind of things like watching videos and songs will give you a basic knowledge of the French culture and will open yourself to different kinds of vocabulary which is needed for the language. You can also speak with your French friends or friends who are learning French. This will help your conversation skills. Moving on, we at Seven Isles International School take the complete responsibility that we inspire our children. But it is also necessary that the parents support their children at the same time. French is a bit difficult subject when it comes to learning a new language, but it can be also on a scoring side if you practice every day, because language cannot be learned in one single day. Thank you and regards. If you have any queries or questions, you can write to me on meghnakargutkar.sicis@gmail.com.
Hello parents, welcome to new academic year 2021-22. Myself Arun Singh, homeroom teacher of grade 10. This academic year I will teach grade 6 maths, grade 7 maths and physics, and 8 to 10 physics. Now I'll brief you about subject maths. Math helps us to think analytically and develop better reasoning abilities. Students become more competent and proficient in doing calculations which they can apply in their everyday life.
Textbooks and workbook for mathematics which we'll be using for grade 6 and 7 are Checkpoint Maths 1 student book and workbook for grade 6. For grade 7, Checkpoint Maths 2 student book and workbook. Assessments. Our whole academic year is divided into two terms, term 1 and term 2. In term 1, we conduct unit test 1 and term 1. In term 2, we conduct unit test 2 and term 2. The pattern of exams are as follows. If we conduct offline exam, then unit tests are of 25 marks, which is converted into 100%. Term 1 and term 2 are of 7, theory paper is of 70 marks and internal assessment of 30 marks, total 100 marks. If we conduct online exam, unit tests are of 30 marks, theory 20 marks and oral exams of 10 marks, total makes 30. Terms exams, theory paper of 70 marks, IA 30 marks and oral exams are of 20 marks, total 120, which is converted into 100%. The detail of the exam pattern is given in the tabular form. Details of internal assessment. Homework and classwork 5 marks, mental maths 10 marks, class test 15 marks, total 30 marks. Class test we conduct weekly basis. Suppose in the subject a student writes 6 exams, we consider best 5 and convert it into 15 marks. We don't take re-exam for absent student. For any query, you can write to me at arun.sicis@gmail.com or you can call at school landline number 256-33693. Hello parents, welcome to new academic year 2021-22. Myself Arun Singh. This academic year I will teach grade 7 and 8 physics. Physics helps learner to understand the technological world in which they live and take an informed interest in science and scientific developments. The syllabus includes the basic principle and concept that are fundamental to the subject, some current application of physics, and a strong emphasis on practical skills. Textbooks and workbooks for physics for grade 7 and 8. For grade 7, complete physics for Cambridge Lower Secondary students book. Complete physics for Cambridge Lower Secondary workbook. One request to the parents of grade 7, please keep this book safely. Next academic year, that is for grade 8 also, we are going to use same book. For grade 8, Cambridge Checkpoint Science students book and Cambridge Science workbook. Our academic calendar is divided into two terms, term 1 and term 2. In term 1, we conduct two tests, unit test 1 and term 1. In term 2, we conduct unit test 2 and term 2. Exam pattern. If we conduct offline exam, that means conducting exams in school, unit test is of 25 marks, which is converted to 100%. Term 1 and term 2 is of 70 marks theory paper, internal assessment 30 marks, total 100%. If we conduct online exams, then unit test is of 20 marks, 10 marks oral exam, total 30 marks, which is converted to 100%. Terms exam. Theory paper is of 70 marks, internal assessment of 30 marks, oral of 20 marks, total 120 marks, which is converted to 100%. Now internal assessment. Internal assessment have many components like homework and classwork 5 marks, assignment 5 marks, project carries 5 marks, and class test carries 15 marks. Total 30 marks. This internal marks of 30 is included in term exam. For any query or suggestion, you can write to me at arun.sicis@gmail.com or you can contact school landline number 256-33693.
Hello everyone. Welcome to the Parents Orientation Program. I am Miss Jacqueline Mary. I am the homeroom teacher of grade 9. This year I am going to handle chemistry for grade 6 to 10 and the grade 6 physics. The Cambridge Checkpoint Science syllabus enables learners to understand the technological world in which where they live and take an informed interest in science and the scientific developments. Learners gain an understanding of the basic principle of chemistry and physics through a mix of theoretical and practical studies. They also develop an understanding of scientific skills for further study at Cambridge IGCSE and international A-level skills which are useful in everyday life. As they progress, learners understand how science is studied and practiced and become aware that results of scientific research can have both good and bad effects on individuals, communities and environment.
Now I am going to give brief explanation about grade 7 and 8 chemistry content. The topics which will be covered for this year for grade 7 chemistry, states of matter, material properties and material changes. the content for grade 8 chemistry, material properties and material changes. In material properties, we are going to study about structure of atom and the first 20 elements in the periodic table. In material changes, we are going to study about the different types of reaction and the reactivity series and the preparation of salt. Assessment and evaluation. Students are evaluated on the basis of the following components for internal assessment. This information will be useful for you to prepare your what for the test. Classwork, homework and worksheet for 5 marks. Class test 15 marks. Project or lab 10 marks. Total 30 marks internal assessment. For unit test 1 and 2, they have 25 marks theory paper, no internal assessment. For term 1 and 2, they have 70 marks theory paper and 30 marks internal assessment. Resources. These are the grade 7 and 8 chemistry textbooks. If you have any doubts, you can write to me at jacqueline.sicas@gmail.com. I am looking forward for this academic year. Thank you once again.
A very good morning to each and every one of you. The school year at Seven Isles International School is about to commence, and I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you all once again. I'm Mrs. Bindu Anand. I'll be teaching biology for grade 7, 8, 9, and 10. It's very important that you and your child are fully informed regarding the assessment criteria. The school assessment begins in the classroom. Each teacher evaluates the students every day, observing their responses to questions, completion of homework, contribution to class, acquisition of specific skills and concepts. Periodically, student assessment will be done with more formal measures like class tests. All these contribute to 30% of the internal assessment. Apart from all this, in the school, each term has one unit test and one term exam. This is to measure students' ability to answer well-structured questions. The COVID-19 pandemic is having a very real effect on all of us, as well as all of us in India and around the world. I appeal to students and parents to value and uphold the importance of intrinsic motivation. We teachers will also make sure that our students will remain motivated in the online classroom. I request all students to attend the class daily, join on time, ready for the day's learning experience. Complete all the homework assignments given to them on time. Respect your parents, obey your teachers, and believe in yourself. Wish you all a grand and successful year ahead. Welcome you all once again. Thank you and have a nice day.
Good morning, dear parents. I would like to welcome you for this orientation program for the academic year 2021 and 2022. I am Vishwas Rao Shinde. I will be teaching humanities for grade 6, 7 and 8. Humanities studies all aspects of human society and culture. Humanities inspired the student to become global citizen by exploring their own place in the world. Humanities help us to understand others through their culture, their history, and their language. Humanities enable the learners to acquire the knowledge of physical, social environment, and thus broadens their outlook and even thinking horizon also. Humanities help the student to become very informed and responsible citizen in future. See, let us see the objectives of the humanities. Objectives of the humanities are encourage the student to gain and develop knowledge, conceptual understanding, analytical and interpretive skills, and communication skills. So, syllabus of the humanities mainly includes these three subjects: history, geography, and civics. The students will be having one combined textbook for all these three subjects during this academic year. The textbook is Integrated Social Science Landmark. The assessment of the humanities includes mainly term exam and unit tests. Throughout the year, we will be conducting two-term exams was 70 marks theory and 30 mark internal assessment and unit test for 25 mark. Each term one unit test. So let us see the components of the internal assessment. There are four major components of the internal assessment. Homework and classwork for 5 marks, worksheet and assignment for 5 marks, project work and oral for 5 marks, and class test for 15 marks. Class test will be conducted periodically throughout the term, and we'll take the average of the all class tests, and it will be included in the term exam in the internal assessment. So this is about the humanities curriculum and assessment. Dear parents, if you have any queries, you can send me the mail. My email ID is sinde.sicis@gmail.com. Thank you and have a nice day.
Hello parents, good morning. I am Ms. Ashwini, ICT teacher of grade 6, 7 and 8. As we all know, technology plays an important role in each and everyone's life. Let's see what exactly ICT is. ICT stands for Information, Communication and Technology. Now, ICT is nothing but how we use technology in our day-to-day life, which may include smartphones, desktop computers, laptop computers, gaming gadgets and various other gadgets which we use in our houses for various household activities. Now, let's see why students should learn ICT. As we all know, technology is increasing rapidly nowadays. So learning ICT allows students to interact in digital world by understanding and using applications, by understanding internet and various terms related to internet. Now let's see textbook used in grade 6. So textbook used in grade 6 is Cambridge Connection Computer Studies 6, author is Vaishali Sharma. Topics covered in this textbook are categories of computers and computer languages, file management, organization of data, various application software such as word processing application and presentations, Scratch programming, HTML and internet online survey. Similarly, for grade 7, textbook use is Cambridge Connection Computer Studies 7. Author is Vaishali Sharma and topics covered in this textbook are computer hardware components, troubleshooting, number system, computer virus, safety ethics and safety measures in computing, Excel, editing, formatting content in cell, then database, creating tables and database, raising queries, designing forms and reports in MS Access, HTML. And for grade 8, textbook used is Cambridge Connection Computer Studies 8. Author is Vaishali Sharma and topics covered in grade 8 textbook are graphical user interface and command line interface, operating systems, then MS Excel, various functions used in MS Excel, analyzing, creating graphs and charts in MS Excel by using some sort of data, then algorithms and flowcharts, C++ program coding, basics and advanced, then networks, different types of networks and app development, all these things will be covered in grade 8 textbook. Now let's come to exam format for grade 6, 7 and 8. Exam format is like if the exams are conducted offline, unit test will be of 25 marks theory paper, term 1 exam theory paper will be of 60 marks, internal assessment will be of 40 marks which will be divided as 15 marks for class test, 20 marks for practical exams and 5 marks for classwork, homework, assessment, worksheets which will be given in the class. And similarly, if the exams are conducted online, theory paper will be of 70 marks, internal assessment will be of 30 marks and 20 marks oral exam will be there for term exam. And for unit test, 20 marks theory paper will be there and 5 marks oral exam will be there, total 25 marks. Thank you. Looking forward for the coming academic year.
Good morning. I am Anju Sibyl and I will be teaching the art and design subject. Art and design is important because it makes children more creative and imaginative, and it brings about certain mental disciplines in the children. For example, they learn to draw better diagrams in other subjects and their handwriting improves. This year, children can use water or poster colors, whatever they have. and children will be learning different type of drawings using markers, brush pens, etc. They will be doing drawings like stippling, Madhubani art, Tanjore painting, etc. Children can improve their drawing by following some points which are very important. First is practice. Practice is the most important one. Children should practice drawing at least half an hour every day. And children should always remember that they should start drawing simple drawings rather than difficult ones. Children should remember that they should always complete the drawing what they have drawn. It's not necessary to complete the drawing at one stretch. They can take regular intervals and complete the drawing which they have made. And parents can motivate the children by encouraging them by giving positive remarks at the drawing which they have drawn. And even they can spare some time and do some drawing and coloring with them. Thank you.
Everyone, my name is Mr. Dinesh Patil. I teach physical education in 7th International School to the students of grade 6 to 10. Our school give much importance to the sports because it's play major part in improving your physical and mental fitness and also helps in developing self-confidence, team spirit and mentally and physical toughness. It also enhances our physical and mental coordination. Due to this current situation of pandemic, offline classes are not possible. So, in the online classes, I teach standing yoga, sitting yoga, power yoga, as well as various exercises such as fartlek training, circuit training, aerobics, and other fun games. When the offline school will resume, I'll also teach the students outdoor games such as cricket, football, basketball, handball, athletics, as well as indoor games such as chess, carrom, table tennis. Till then, stay healthy and safe. Thank you.
Hey Ishvara Sarvana, चांगली बुद्धी दे, आरोग्य दे, सर्वांना सुखात आनंदात ऐश्वर्यात ठेव. सर्वांचं भलं कर, कल्याण कर, रक्षण कर, आणि तुझे गोड नाव मुखात अखंड राहू दे.
हॅलो एव्हरीवन, माय सेल्फ मिस्टर सिद्धेश गंधट. I would like to speak on music. First, what are the objective of music? Music has multiple side effects on the human body. Music is a medium of outward activity and inward experience. It has direct relation to speech and language with communication through bodily expression and dance to a range of emotion and to the perception and recognition of sound patterns and forms. Let me make one announcement. While school was working offline, we used to conduct music celebration in the classroom. But due to pandemic situation, henceforth we will be conducting music celebration grade-wise through Facebook and YouTube. Now let's talk about the syllabus content of our school. While studying the Cambridge IGCSE music syllabus, learners listen to perform and compose music encouraging aesthetic and emotional development, self-discipline and creativity. This gives them appreciation and enjoyment of music. Research on speech skills focuses on rhythm and perception. It also gives an idea of accent of and fluency. While learning music, speech skills are very important. Primarily, it is used for recreation, for self-expression, improvement of speech and language development. It also provides personal satisfaction and source of social pleasure. Now let's talk about vocal accuracy. Vocal accuracy are early vocal training, appropriate models and feedback, and instrumental are accompaniment. Additional time with daily vocal exercise and vocal assembles. Breathe is very important in vocal music, like ability to cope with breathing patterns while singing in a group. Auditory skills are of great importance. It is a complex task of listening and can become highly structured. It gives natural motivation of using residual hearing. Last but not the least, social skills. It contains group music, promotes sharing, mutual attentiveness, responsibility to the group, an enjoyable sense of partnership in activities that demand a cooperative effort for successful accomplishment. I conclude my words by this famous quote: music washes away from the soul the dust of everyday life. For any queries, kindly mail me at siddesh.sics@gmail.com. Thank you, everyone.